The computers of tomorrow will be so smart, we won't understand how they solve their problems. But don't panic! We'll make them explain it to us. Computer intelligence is fascinating. Whether it's a supercomputer that has enough processors to tackle complicated problems with brute force, or a sophisticated algorithm that allows you to teach rather than program a machine, artificial intelligence is cool. But we're running up against a problem. Computers and algorithms are getting so sophisticated that sometimes it can be difficult or even impossible to figure out how a computer arrived at a particular solution. Take, for example, the Stampede cluster at the Texas Advanced Computing Center. In May 2016, this supercomputer with 800 cores tackled a doozy of a mathematical question that had challenged mathematicians since the 1980s. It took approximately 2 days to suss out the answer. The question, by the way, was, can you separate all natural numbers into two sets in which neither set contains a Pythagorean triple? You remember the Pythagorean theorem, right? That's the one about right triangles in which the square of the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides. In other words, a squared plus b squared equals c squared. So, could you divide up all natural numbers into two sets in which neither set contained a Pythagorean triple? The answer, the computer discovered, is no. But it took 200 terabytes of data to get there. That's way too much information for a human to comb through. And therein lies the problem. Computers are giving us answers to questions, and it's getting harder for us to know how they came up with that answer. And this is just the tip of the iceberg. I've talked in the past about artificial neural networks. These are computer networks that imitate the way our brains work, using computer nodes to represent neurons. Here's the problem. A large artificial neural network rapidly approaches a level of complexity so great that even the network's creators can't be sure how a machine arrives at any particular answer. The artificial neural network becomes a black box, meaning its inner workings are a mystery. As Arthur C. Clarke observed, any sufficiently advanced technology is indistinguishable from magic. We don't want the use of an artificial neural network to be the equivalent of consulting an oracle. This could lead to some dangerous situations. If we put complicated systems to work for us, they may come up with solutions that are actually not the best option for us to follow. There could be a flaw in the computer's reasoning, but if it's a really complicated system, that flaw might not be obvious. And unless we know how the machines came to that answer, we may not know there's a problem until it's too late. Researchers at MIT are working to overcome this challenge. The MIT Computer Science Artificial Intelligence Laboratory, also known as CSAIL, has been working on a system in which artificial neural networks have to provide not just an answer, but explain the rationale behind that answer. And they're using this approach to make artificial neural networks research breast cancer. Meanwhile, researchers at Chongqing University are using a special algorithm to pull decision-making trees from an artificial neural network's processing to trace the sequences the network used to come to a conclusion. The bigger the artificial neural network, the harder this is to do. Imagine taking one of those old choose-your-own-adventure books and mapping out every single possible sequence, and you start to get the idea. Many of the tasks artificial neural networks are tackling today are pretty trivial. It could involve color correction, image recognition, voice recognition, and other basic aspects of machine intelligence. But as we build computers to look at weightier problems, we'll really want to be sure they're making the best decisions possible. So let's make sure we require computers to show their work. What question would you ask an all-knowing computer? Let me hear your thoughts in the comments below. Thanks to Toyota for sponsoring this episode and making it possible. You can support our show by clicking that little like button and subscribe to our channel to join the forward-thinking think tank. And you can learn more about the possibilities of the future in these videos right over here.